Today on the BV3D channel, I'll show you how printing more multicolor models can actually waste less filament. I'm Brian, and you are watching BV3D. Hi, welcome back. Okay, so today we're going to see a tip on how to reduce waste when printing multicolor models, such as with a Bambu lab printer with an AMS or automatic material system. And this also applies to other filament swapping systems like the Purge MMU too. Now, a lot of people think that being able to print multicolor models on a single nozzle 3D printer is pretty cool, and I'm one of them. But what you may not necessarily think about is how much filament gets wasted when changing colors. Every time the printer swaps filament, it has to flush out the first filament color by pushing the new filament color through the nozzle. Watching the nozzle during the purge, you can initially see that color swap happening, but what you don't necessarily see is that the new color isn't pure yet. The first color is still bleeding into it. So going from red to white, there's a fairly sharp transition to a lighter color, but that color is actually kind of pink. The printer has to flush more white filament through the nozzle until it gets the red out, like Visine. It doesn't have to flush quite as much filament through the nozzle when going from a lighter color to a darker color, though. Going from white to red, for instance, will use less filament because the red overpowers the white. But here's the problem. Printing this two-color 3.6 gram poker chip requires the printer to flush 11 grams of filament. In other words, three times the amount of filament that was used to print the model is purge waste, and purge waste is a big problem. So I'm going to show you one way to help solve the persistent purge problem plaguing printers. Now there are other ways, but this is the one I'm focusing on today. And it's actually really, really simple. Now, I like this two-color poker chip. It was designed by a GetBiz, and I downloaded it from printables.com. And there's a link to it in the description if you want to download and print it yourself. It's a free model. When printed alone, this two-color poker chip has a 3-to-1 waste-to-model ratio. So this weighs three times as much as this. But I'll show you how to turn that around and get the waste down to just a fraction of the model weight. This may sound counterintuitive, but we'll get less waste by printing more. Yep, by printing as many of the model as possible at the same time, the total waste stays exactly the same. It's still 11 grams of waste. But instead of one model with 11 grams of waste, I was able to squeeze 13 models onto the Bambu Lab A1 Mini's build plate. Now, that 11 grams of waste can be divided up between the 13 poker chips. And that means each poker chip's share of the waste is something like 0.85 grams of filament, so it's less than 1 gram per model. By printing 13 of them, each chip has something like a 0.23-to-1 waste-to-model ratio. In other words, instead of the waste being three times the weight of the model, it's less than a third of the model's weight. Hey, if you're finding this video helpful or informative, a subscribe would really mean a lot to me. That lets me know that with all the work I put into these videos, I'm making useful content that you enjoy. Thanks. Now, unfortunately, there is a side effect to printing multiple copies of a multicolor model at once, and that's how it affects the printing time. Printing one of these poker chips with two colors takes about an hour. Now, normally, excluding printer warm-up time, printing 13 copies of a thing takes 13 times as long as printing just one of that thing. The printer has to make the same moves to print each thing, and those all take the same amount of time, right? Right. But remember, this is a multicolor model, so part of that 1 hour print time for the single poker chip is the time it takes to do the color swaps. Oh wait, did I say unfortunately? I meant fortunately, as in fortunately, the same way that the amount of waste stays the same whether we print one or 13 of the poker chips, the number of color swaps also stays the same. The time for each swap gets divided by the number of models too. So 1 hour to print one, and instead of 13 hours to print 13, it's only about 3.5 hours. So printing multiple copies of a multicolor model not only wastes less filament per model, it also takes less time per model. The one issue I found with this has to do with the filament purge estimates in the Bambu Studio Slicer software. When slicing just the one poker chip, the purge estimates, that's the flushed column here, are pretty accurate. But when I slice 13 at once, those estimates are all kinds of wrong. It thinks it's going to flush over 38 grams of filament while doing purges, and this clearly isn't the case. I have the purge waste right here, and it's the same 11 grams as when printing just one poker chip. It also thinks it's going to use 51 grams of filament to print the 13 chips, and it really only used about 47 grams. That estimate is off by more than one chip's worth of filament. In fact, the total estimated filament usage by weight for 13 chips is over 89 grams, while the actual filament usage is only 58 grams, including the purge waste. So I feel like Bambu Lab needs to revisit the code that handles those calculations to bring the estimates closer to reality. Now, one thing I want to mention about this scale is that it measures in 1 gram increments. So when the weight of an object is just over something and a half grams, the scale rounds that something up to the next whole number. So when I weigh a 3.6 gram poker chip, the scale rounds up to 4 grams. How do I know the chips weigh 3.6 grams when putting a single chip on the scale shows 4 grams? Because 10 of them weighs 36 grams, and 36 divided by 10 is 3.6. Oh, side note, did you know the division symbol actually has a name? It's called the gazenta, as in 9 gazenta 18 three times. Okay, so as weird as it sounds, printing more wastes less. Plus, it's quicker. Give this a try the next time you're going to be printing a multicolor model. You'll get done sooner and use less filament compared to printing a bunch of that model one at a time. So that's it. That's the tip of the day. Big thanks to everyone who supports the channel, whether with channel memberships or by using the links in the description. If you liked this one, give it a thumbs up and maybe consider subscribing so you don't miss future episodes. Well, 3D printing friends, that's about all the time we have for this one. And now that we're at the end, let's go print something cool.